Hey everyone, Mike here, and in this video we'll put the Windows Phone 8X by HTC next to the Samsung Galaxy S3. Tag along and also check my full reviews for these two phones posted in the description below. On a first look, the two are miles apart, but when shopping for a top smartphone right now, they are both up there in the lists as flagships for Android and Windows Phone 8 ecosystems. After using both these phones for a while, I can say that the HTC 8X is definitely the better looking of the two, thanks to its polycarbonate body that integrates perfectly with the glass on top, resulting in an awesome slab of technology. The plastic-covered Samsung ain't bad either, but I for one have never been a big fan of that cheap-looking glossy finishing. On the other hand, the HTC only comes with a 4.3-inch screen, while the Samsung sports a larger 4.8-inch one. That should have made the HTC significantly more compact, but that's not the case here, as the Windows Phone 8 power handset packs wide bezel. As a result, both phones feel pretty much the same in hand, and neither can be actually used with your thumb, unless you're playing in the NBA or something. When it comes to utility, both these phones pack cameras with flash on the back, front-facing shooters as well, plus the standard set of ports and connectors. You'll find volume rockers, power buttons, and the micro USB port on the two. The HTC 8X also has a dedicated shutter button, while the Samsung apps the game with a micro SD card reader hidden behind that rear panel that allows you to increase the storage space, something you won't be able to do with the HTC. Speaking of that, the back cover is removable on the Galaxy S3, allowing access to the battery, SIM slot and the card reader, while on the HTC everything is enclosed and the micro SIM tray is placed on the upper right side of the phone. Of course, the screens are the ones that could make or break a modern handset, and both these phones pack very good displays. There's the 4.3-inch Super LCD 2 panel on the HTC and the 4.8-inch Super AMOLED panel on the Samsung, both sporting 1280x720 pixels in resolution. Colors, brightness, viewing angles aren't something you should be concerned with either of these displays, but there are differences between the two. The AMOLED screen on the Samsung offers better contrast and deeper levels of black, while the Super LCD 2 is a bit more accurate when it comes to color reproduction, but blacks are rather washed on it. Also, there's the pentile panel on the Samsung, with its potential downsides, and the laminated Gorilla Glass 2 on the HTC makes the content seem somewhat more realistic, like floating on the screen and not hidden beneath a layer of glass like on most other phones. On the front faces, you'll also find some buttons for either Windows or Android on the two devices, plus the front-facing cameras, the notification LEDs, the light sensor and the speaker grills on top of the screen. All in all, I'd say that the HTC 8X is better looking and feels sturdier, more reliable than the Samsung. But when it comes to the practical aspect, the Galaxy S3 does offer more features and an increased screen estate, while it's not much larger or heavier than its rival here. The HTC 8X is built on a dual-core Crate processor with 1GB of RAM and 16GB of storage. There's the same amount of RAM and storage on the Samsung, but a quad-core Exynos processor, so on paper the S3 might seem more powerful than the 8X. In practice though, the two phones are close. Have a look at some benchmarks below. Also, when it comes to everyday activities, both the HTC and the Samsung are snappy and stutter-free. Of course, the software has something to say here as well, and it's quite complicated to compare devices built on completely different platforms, but if you want to see which of these two is faster when dealing with daily tasks, have a look at the next part of this video. Like I said in the beginning, both these phones are flagships for their ecosystems. But while Android has a couple of years down the line, Windows Phone 8 is brand new. Thus, you shouldn't be amazed that when it comes to the apps you're using often, the Samsung Galaxy S3 is the more versatile option. But for everyday activities, Windows Phone 8 is a worthy competitor. Its minimalistic design and the pretty straightforward actions are easy to understand and use, while Android can be a bit cluttered, especially for new users. Both phones can deal with the basic activities, like taking and receiving calls, texting, browsing, watching movies, listening to music or playing games. Once again though, when it comes to third-party apps, the Android ecosystem is clearly superior. For instance, Gmail, YouTube, Twitter, Facebook or Skype are things available on both platforms, but on Windows Phone 8 they are full of bugs and issues. And then there are many apps that can't even be found on Windows Phone 8, at least for now. On the other hand, Microsoft plans to create a unified experience with all their Windows-powered devices, whether we're talking about Windows 8 Pro computers, Windows RT tablets or Windows Phone 8 handsets. And that, if it's ever going to happen, would make your tech life easier, but it's just not here for the time being. There are 8 megapixel cameras on the back of both these devices, with back illuminated sensors and flash. The HTC comes with an f2.0 lens, while on the Samsung there's a narrower f2.6 lens. But on the other hand, both phones offer intuitive camera interfaces, and while there are more options you can configure on the Samsung, the HTC is up there close as well. As for the results, well, here they are. You should decide for yourself which one of the two handsets takes better pictures. I've added some clips as well, shot with the rear-facing 1080p camera. The HTC 8X come with an encased 1800 mAh battery, while on the Samsung there's an easily replaceable 2100 mAh one. The other side, the two phones are both able to last through the day with medium use and even more with light use. And while both phones will go for 10 plus hours of 3G talk and about 6 hours of continuous browsing, the Samsung tends to last longer than the HTC when playing movies or music. But the two are close, and I can't say that battery life plays a decisive role in this comparison. This is actually where the HTC Windows Phone 8X has a slight edge in some markets, as it tends to be more affordable than the Samsung Galaxy S3, especially when paired with contracts. In the US, for instance, the HTC starts at $99, while the Samsung starts at $199. However, over here, the two both start at around 99 euros with 2-year plans, and off contract, they sell for pretty much the same kind of money, around 450 euros. In the end, choosing between these two devices is not an easy task. The HTC might have the price on its side, but is this one, next to the looks, the build quality and the new OS, enough to make you lean towards the 8X over an already acknowledged success, the Samsung Galaxy S3? Well, that depends, and it's up to each of you to decide. So please tell me which one of these two handsets would you choose right now and why. Make sure to leave your replies below, and also go ahead and subscribe to my channel and share this video to your friends if you liked it. I'll catch you later.